we read, we come across some new and unfamiliar words, right? While a dictionary is quite useful in helping us find the meanings to such words, referring to it every time we come across a new word can break the flow of our reading. We don't actually want to go to a dictionary every time, right? So in such cases, knowing about LUPRC strategy to predict the word meanings can be very helpful. So let's learn more about it. So children, for learning about the same, I'm going to take you through a presentation based on LUPRC strategy. Yeah. So now, LUPRC is a strategy that can be used to find the meanings of new words or phrases in a sentence. All right. So now, what does LUPRC stands for? So it stands for, L stands for look for clues. Then U is to understand the words. P is to predict the meaning. R is to read the sentence. And C is for checking the meaning from the dictionary, of course. So now, since L stands for look for clues, the first step is to look for the clues. So let us learn about different kinds of clues that are hidden inside the sentences only. Now, there are different types of clues, children. Alright, so these are the different types of clues we should look out to find the meanings of new words or phrases in a story. So you could have a definition or a synonym or an antonym or an example or an inference as a clue given in the sentence itself, which can actually let you find the meaning of the word very easily. So let's find out how. So what is a definition, number one? The word is defined or explained in the sentence itself. So when you have the definition of the word given in the text itself, you need not go to a dictionary, right? So let's take an example. So the corridor was dark and appeared frightening. It was most gloomy corridor I had ever came across. So when I read this sentence, I understand that there are two lines explaining the very same corridor. Right? So one says it was dark and appeared frightening and the other says it was gloomy. So can I understand that the meaning of the new word gloomy must be dark and appeared frightening? Right? So that's how we can explain it. Gloomy means something that is dark and appears as depressing or frightening. Understood, children? Now the next one, which is a synonym. So a word which has a similar meaning is already used and gives a hint what the other word might mean. So we can understand it like that also. For example, I can say that I am glad and happy. So both of these are positive emotions, so I can understand the meaning right there. Let's see an example. The drawings on the walls of the cave captured the impressions of the events that happened when people lived in those cages. So you have impressions as a new word and drawings as a synonym. So by which I can understand that these might mean something similar. And well, I am right. Impressions are the pictures in the form of drawings. Understood? So these are the similar meaning words that you can find within the text. Now, children, coming to antonym. So you, in this case, you will have a word which has the opposite meaning is used and gives the hint what the other word might mean. So for example, dark and light. So these are the two words which are exactly opposite in meaning and are the examples of antonyms. Now you can see a sentence like, Meeta was a clever and studious girl in her youth. Who would have thought that the same girl could behave so daffy? So when I read the new word daffy and then I read the same girl, these words, the same girl, and then I read so. So these basically indicate something that is contrary to what is given to you before. So with this, I can understand that whatever had happened before, right now she is the opposite of it. So initially she was clever, right? So now she is daffy. So what would daffy mean? Stupid or silly. And how could I understand that? With the antonym which was given right there in the text. That was clever in this case for the word daffy. Understood, children? Now coming to the example. So an example of the word is used to suggest its meaning. So for example, when I read the word monument and I read the word Qutub Minar, in case I do not know the meaning of the word monument, I can understand that Qutub Minar is basically some historic building by which I can understand that monument might also mean something similar to it, right? Let's read an example for the same.